I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay.
And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. I am so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart.
Good morning. My name is Samuel Babb, and I am a member of the St. Helens Christian Mission Church. My devotion is entitled, God's School of Discipline, taken from Hebrews chapter 12, verse 11. Now no chastening for the present seems to be joyous, but grievous. Nevertheless, afterward, it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness unto them which are exercised thereby. I can see the champion in me being brought out of the art of submission to God. No chastening seems to be joyful for the present, but painful. As we accept God's discipline, and with deep exercise, we allow Him to train and correct us, we will benefit from God's test and pass it with good results. Afterward, it yieldeth the peaceable fruit of righteousness to those who are trained by it. Job understood this when on the great trial. He observed in Job chapter 28, verse 28, submission to God is wisdom. He said, "Behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom, and to depart from evil is understanding." Through his acceptance of God's discipline, he overcame his sorrows with great results. So the Lord blessed the latter end of Job more than his beginning, for he had 14,000 feet and 6,000 camels. And 1,000 feet ashes. God gave him seven more sons and three daughters, and in all the land were no women found so fair as the daughters of Job. And their father gave them an inheritance among their brethren. After this lived Job 140 years, and saw his sons and his grandsons, even 4 generations, a champion in his own right. We learn of Daniel and many others who humbled themselves under the mighty hand of God, and as a result of their testings, were highly honored in their respective countries. Let us keep doing what is right, as Jesus always did, and follow Him and His perfect example, as believers maintain His rights in a world that rejects Him. Soon Jesus will be honored worldwide, and every knee will bow to Him. The red carpet of honor will be rolled out for us in eternity after much testing and true perseverance. Fittingly summarized by Paul in the words of 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 5, 7, and 8. When we endure affliction, make full proof of our ministry, fight a good fight, finish the course, and keep the faith. Then there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day. And not only to me, but unto all those who love His appearing. So you see, there is a champion in each of us waiting to emerge, to be the champion that God has called you to be.
I've got the joy.